Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to another quick pick prediction video. In this video, I'll be predicting the middleweight bout between Omari Akhmedov versus Brad Tavares. So you got two veterans here that have been around the UFC for a good minute. Brad Tavares, I think, around for a good minute. That's what I'm trying to say. I doubled up the four instead of the good, you know, brain kind of doing things, but for a good minute. Omari Akhmedov been around for a good minute. But how I see him right here is Omari Akhmedov does have a very good shot, and I was actually going to lean to him. You know where I'm going with this. I'm leaning to Brad Tavares. Brad Tavares at one point actually had the highest takedown defense in middleweight history at one point. I think it was like 89 or 90 or 95 at one point, until he fought Yoel Romero, and Romero took him down 7 times and was just hitting with all types of different throws. But even outside of that, it hasn't really, to this day, his takedown defense has held up. It's not like 89 or 95 where it used to be because of Romero, but it's still with like a 79%, which is still extremely high. And I think he's fought in better wrestlers since and better grapplers since then too. So, and it's been holding up. So he's going against Omari Akhmedov, who's a solid wrestler, powerhouse striker. Well, it's not like a clean striker. I'm not saying this. He got power in his hand. He's not a technical striker by any means. Definitely not some guy off the couch striker, but definitely, you know, the UFC caliber, but not, you know, upper echelon or really the right home about, but power, pressure, and wrestling, what he brings. But I feel like with that style against Tavares already having, you know, good solid wrestling defense, decent speed, decent eyes, decent experience, decent fight IQ, decent this and decent all that, I think he'll be able to see that. It's not like the case of Akhmedov is going to be being so tricky. He's not going to be out there moving on angles and stuff, mixing the feints and blast double legs and low singles. It's not going to be a case of where he's so tricky. Yes, he's going to be powerful and explosive. That's how he gets people down, and, you know, decent technique as well. But again, it's stuff that you're going to be able to see is coming. You're going to know it's coming. And yes, he might be able to lift you up, but Brad Tavares has good balance and will be able to adjust. And I feel like he'll be able to stuff the large majority of the takedowns. And also, Akhmedov is not a guy that has taken down people who, like, you know, has ever had a higher rate of takedowns. I think the most takedowns he ever scored was 3. You know, average score is like 1. So it's not a case of a guy that's, you know, out there relentless with the wrestling. It's not like he'll throw a bunch of overhands, put you on the back foot, and then maybe go for like 1 takedown, or probably like 3 or 4 takedowns, and probably at most get 1. That's the case with him. And that's not even against the best takedown defense people. That's against like just about everyone. So it's not like a case where he's a super high cardio fighter. And at times he's a fighter who fades and fights. Not like Tavares has good cardio, good conditioning, well-rounded, good skill fighter. And I think, and also has that takedown defense, that one time the best takedown defense in the middleweight history. So I feel like he'll be able to adjust to the wrestling of Akhmedov, I'll be able to address it. It'll be a lot of power and try to force things. And I think Akhmedov will be able to get a takedown in the fight, but I think Brad Tavares will be able to stand up. I think he'll be able to defend most of them. I think he will definitely be able to address the wrestling. You know, on the feet, I think Tavares is just a longer, better striker. And I think he will make that case. I think he'll be able to stuff takedowns, put up the volume on Akhmedov. Might even potentially get a stoppage on Akhmedov, but I think at most he'll probably, I'm thinking he'll probably just rock him, maybe get a drop. I don't think he'll secure the finish, but I think it'll be a case where Akhmedov might get a decent bit of control time, but no real true takedowns, top control or anything like that. And whereas Tavares will be able to defend the takedowns, land, you know, shots against the cage, be able to spin off, and then be able to take advantage of a tired and frustrated Akhmedov not being able to get these takedowns, not being able to land these power shots, coming up and missing and touching air. He might touch Brad Tavares once or twice. He's obviously going to touch him more than once or twice, but I'm talking about like real clean shots. And Tavares does have a soft chin, so I feel like he'll be able to land a couple of those. But nothing to the point of fight any stuff. But that's the stuff that's going to buzz Tavares with his glass chin out there. But outside of that, I think Tavares will be able to weather with the storm, defend the takedowns, and take advantage of an aggressive and frustrated Akhmedov. And then later on, a tired and frustrated, sloppy Akhmedov, and beat him to a decision. So in this one, I got Brad Tavares via decision.